conferences every year. They start in January and they go to May. Every month we have a different academy. The first one is usually towards the middle of January. Then we have another one in February, March, April, and then we graduate in May. So we're at our graduation celebration, stopping for a moment to talk to you about why this has been such a blessing. But before I do that, I would like to let you know them both a little bit more, because you'll be seeing them in the future at our academies, even maybe teaching and speaking at our academy for 2019. Laurin, it's just been a pleasure to know you over the years. You're just such an awesome person. And everyone that I know that knows you, they can't get enough of you. Even at work, they're like, please come back, Laurin. Please come back. We want you to work here. She could leave a job and 5 years later, they're still asking for her to come back. She nannies and people are like, please come watch my kid again. So there's something special about you. There's an anointing on your life that just draws people and causes them to feel like they want to be around you. But I am really super excited to tell you something else. That even though Laurin can't come back to all these people and be with them all the time, you can bring Laurin to your house. Did you know that? You can bring Laurin to your house starting in 2019, wherever you are. And what do I mean by that? That sounds kind of weird, right? Laurin is an author, and she has a book coming out. What's the name of your book, Laurin? Can you tell us a little about it?
Yes, so my book will be called Unashamed, and it's a little bit about my story. Well, maybe a lot about my story. But it's just sharing my journey through brokenness and just growing up with my life with abuse and dealing with that, and just seeing how God has transformed me from being a broken, quiet, scared little girl to flourishing into a woman that God has created me to be.
I've been thinking about that lately, actually, Laurin, with woman and abuse. And I remember there was a time at Clark Atlanta University, I believe it was, and we were invited to a ministry event there. And there was a mixture of men and women there, but a girl got up and she shared how she was molested when she was a child. And for some reason, it was just the move of God. Person after person all started saying that happened to me and me. It was like the Me Too movement years ahead.
Wow.
And it got to the point where almost every person in that room had said they'd been through abuse. And I was stunned, because there was over 100 people in there. And these are all college students. And I think about it, but when I think about abuse, a lot of times, I love the title of your book, because I've been thinking about this lately, how women, when they're abused, or when they go through sickness, or when they go through things, for some reason, we take that on as if it's our fault, or as if we should wear the cloak of shame, because it's something that was not even our fault. We weren't causing that. We didn't ask for that. These are little kids, and they're hiding it, and they're feeling ashamed to even let anyone know about it. But they didn't do anything wrong. What do you think about that in our culture? I think that's very interesting, that women carry that shame.
Yes, I think just even the stigma behind it sometimes of, like, you know, it's like, it's a taboo, like, this is something that you
right.
don't talk about, even though it is not your fault, or even if, you know, because these things happen to you, that
right.
you didn't put yourself out there, especially in, even as a child, but even as adult women sometimes going through that, it's like, you're
right.
not, you didn't ask for someone to impose or violate you, so I think that it's good that someone can have a voice and speak out and say, hey, no, it is okay, and then to be able to receive
yeah.
the healing that you need. And first accepting the fact that, no, this is not me, and there's nothing that is not my fault.
Right.
You know, it's not my fault, but also receiving the redemption from God. Like, no, this is how I have been. This is what I see. This is how I've used to receive that healing.
Right. And Tia, you know, I don't know all your story, but I do know that you're a pastor's kid, you know,
yes.
and PKs are always labeled, you know, and it's like, oh, they're going to be bad, and they're going to do all these things, and, you know, they're just that's just what's going to happen to PKs, and then they have that shame, where it's like, they have to live in their parents' shadows. I've heard a lot of PKs say. Do you think that having a book like this, or even maybe at an academy talking about those experiences where you're different for whatever reason, would be helpful to women that are going through even maybe that experience where it's like you didn't do anything wrong. These are both situations where you didn't ask to be a PK. You didn't ask to go through hardship as a child, but all of a sudden you're thrown in it and you have to figure it out.
Right. Yes, I absolutely believe that that would be so helpful, just because when you're put, when people expect something from you and you're not always able to deliver, or they just don't allow you to be yourself. And
right.
when you go through that process with the Lord, and He allows you like to have your own identity, to reclaim your voice, to reclaim mm-hmm. your story, I think that's so important. I feel like that's what most of the struggle is. It's like when people are acting out, they're like, you're not letting me be myself.
Right.
And so I'm excited to read your book.
Me too.
To gain that from your experience. So I'm excited.
Yeah. I love books like that that are not just like a textbook, but they tell a story, because so even if we didn't have the same experience, somewhere in there I'm going to relate to something mm-hmm. that you went through, and it's going to free me. And so, you know, the scripture I think about is Revelation 12:11, that the enemy is defeated by the blood of the Lamb and the word of our testimony. So, we don't like to glorify the enemy, but there is spiritual warfare, and he tries to stop us from sharing that story.
Right.
More than anything else, I think it's what you said, your voice. Having a voice, he tries to just grab our voice and hinder it from ever getting out there to the world, because he knows that there's a lot of other people that will say, yep, that's me.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I relate to that. I've been through that. And there's women, I think that's something women deal with everywhere, is shame. You know, mm-hmm. shame over their body type, shame over their financial situation growing up, shame over abuse, shame from the family they came from. I mean, it could go on and on and on. Shame about the way that they look, they don't think they're as pretty as someone else. It goes on and on, and that needs to be broken. So next year, we're going to be talking about being free to be yourself. We're going to be talking about loosing your voice. We're going to be talking about walking into your calling and your purpose in an unashamed, free way. And that's all been inspired by this woman right here, who has boldly stepped out to come to the forefront to tell her story.